El Niño is warmer than normal waters off the Pacific coast of South America. While it can affect the atmosphere, it is not a storm, does not generate storms, and is not coming to California. What exactly is El Niño and what causes it? Let me explain. Before we talk about what El Niño is, we have to cover two related topics, trade winds and upwelling. Trade winds are winds that flow from east to west near the equator. As the wind blows towards the equator, its direction is bent towards the west because of the rotation of the Earth. Sailing ships have taken advantage of the cross-ocean wind direction for hundreds of years, creating trade routes, which is where the winds get their name. The trade winds also affect the circulation of the water within the ocean. As the wind blows across the ocean, it moves warmer water from the eastern edge towards Asia. This causes a change below the surface. As the water near the surface is pulled by the wind, cold water from deep within the ocean rises to replace it. This is called upwelling, and now we've got a pool of cool water gathered on the surface. That's important because the circulation of the atmosphere near the equator depends on the temperatures of the water, with air rising over the warmer sections of the ocean. But during El Niño, things are different. The trade winds are weaker, meaning that the warmer water isn't being pulled across the Pacific. On top of that, the weaker wind means that upwelling of cold water slows down. An area of warm water starts to form off the Pacific coast of South America. El Niño has started, and you can see that has changed how the atmosphere is circulating. In La Niña years, the opposite of El Niño happens. The trade winds are stronger, upwelling increases, and colder waters collect off the Pacific coast of South America. El Niño is naturally occurring and can affect many areas of the world. While no two El Niños are the same, we may see an increase in Pacific hurricanes and a decrease in Atlantic hurricanes. And while it can change how the atmosphere circulates, it is not a storm, it cannot generate storms, and it's not coming to California. You may also associate El Niño with wet winters, but that's not always the case. Some of our driest years on record have happened during strong El Niños.